Hi, everybody. My name is Marissa, and I have a bachelor's degree in mathematics with a minor in statistics. In today's lesson, we are going to learn when to use a hypothesis test for population proportions, as well as how to apply this test. What do you think of when you hear the word proportion? Generally speaking, proportions allow us to compare a subset of a population in relation to the entire population. For example, if you took a test and got 8 out of 10 questions correct, then the proportion of questions you answered correctly would be 0.80, or 80%. Proportions are essentially percentages in the form of a decimal. While hypothesis tests can be used to make inferences about the mean of a population, they can also be used in the context of population proportions. In order to conduct a hypothesis test for the population proportion, two conditions must be met. The first condition states that the sample from our population should be randomly selected from the population, or it should come from a binomial experiment with independent trials. The second condition states that the sample size times the hypothesized proportion, as well as a sample size times 1 minus the hypothesized proportion, should both be at least 10. The first step in conducting a hypothesis test for the population proportion is setting up our hypotheses. Our hypotheses consist of a null and alternative hypothesis. The parameter in a population proportion hypothesis test is p-naught, and the statistic is p. The null hypothesis will always be in the form of p equals p-naught. An example of a null hypothesis would be the proportion of freshmen at a local high school is 0.03. The alternative hypothesis can be left-tailed, right-tailed, or two-tailed. Left and right-tailed alternative hypotheses are known as one-tailed. A right-tailed hypothesis is in the form of p is greater than p-naught. An example of this would be the proportion of freshmen at a local high school is greater than 0.30. A left-tailed test uses a less than sign rather than a greater than sign. An example of a left-tailed alternative hypothesis would be the proportion of freshmen at a local high school is less than 0.30. A two-tailed test uses a does not equal sign. An example of a two-tailed hypothesis test would be the proportion of freshmen at a local high school is not 0.30. The second step in conducting a hypothesis test for the population proportion is computing the test statistic. A z-test statistic is used for population proportions. A z-test statistic measures the difference between our sample proportion, p-hat, and our hypothesized proportion, p-naught. We compute these values by subtracting p-naught from p-hat and then dividing by the square root of p-naught times 1 minus p-naught divided by n. Going back to our previous example about high school freshmen, let's say that we know that the local high school's proportion of freshmen is 0.27, and the school has a total of 400 students. In order to compute the z-test statistic, we would subtract 0.28 from our previously specified p-naught value of 0.30. We would then divide the square root of 0.30 times 1 minus 0.30 divided by 400. This gives us a result of negative 0.87. Now that we have our test statistic, we can use it to compute our p-value. The p-value represents the probability of obtaining our results if the null hypothesis were true. The lower the p-value, the more extreme our results are. In order to compute the p-value, we will use a z-table. In order to use a z-table, locate the ones and tens place of the test statistic in the column of the z-table and the hundreds place in the rows. Computing our p-value will be dependent on our alternative hypothesis. For a left-tailed test, we just need to find our test statistic on the z-table and use its corresponding value. Using the z-test statistic from our example, we obtain a p-value of 0.1922. If the test is right-tailed, we subtract the value we find on the table from 1. This gives us a result of 0.8078. If our test is two-tailed, and our test statistic is negative, we simply use the method for finding the p-value for a left-tailed test and double it. If it is not negative, we use the method for finding the p-value for a right-tailed test and then double it. This will result in a p-value of 0.3844. Please note that your p-value should always be between 0 and 1. In order to determine whether or not a hypothesis test results in statistical significance, we must compare our p-value to our alpha level. Alpha is the probability of rejecting the null hypothesis if it is true, meaning that if alpha is 0.05, we only have a 5% chance of obtaining our results if the null is in fact true. Unless specified otherwise, alpha is always assumed to be 0.05. Increasing our alpha level makes it less difficult for our results to be statistically significant and vice versa for decreasing it. In order to determine if our results are statistically significant, we must compare our p-value to alpha. Using our p-value results of 0.1922, 0.8078, and 0.3844, we can see that in the case of a left, right, and two-tailed test, all results are above 0.05. This means that our results are not statistically significant and that the proportion of freshmen at a local high school is, in fact, 0.30 or close enough to 0.30. When our results are not statistically significant, we say that we fail to reject the null hypothesis. If our results are statistically significant, we say that we reject the null hypothesis. Making conclusions for our hypothesis test is a straightforward process. If we reject our null hypothesis, just say there is evidence to support the claim of the alternative hypothesis. And if we fail to reject our alternative hypothesis, say there is not enough evidence to support the claim that the alternative hypothesis is true. However, ensure the conclusion is written in the context of the problem. For example, the conclusion of our test regarding high school freshmen would be, there is not enough evidence to support the claim that the true proportion of freshmen at a local high school is more than, slash less than, slash not, 0.30. Due to the various steps involved in conducting a hypothesis test for population proportions, it can be very easy to make mistakes. For starters, it can be easy to incorrectly write the alternative hypothesis. To avoid this, look for keywords such as greater than or more than for right-tailed tests and less than for left-tailed tests. The words have changed or is not are good indicators that we need to use a two-tailed test. Additionally, many students mix up when to reject and to fail to reject their null hypothesis based on their p-value. An analogy I like to use to remember when to reject the p-value is kids trying to ride roller coasters. As a young child, I always wanted to ride big roller coasters, but I was rejected for being too small. In this example, the child is the p-value, and they are getting rejected for being too small. That being said, always reject the p-value if it is smaller than alpha. Great job, everyone. Today we learned about when to use hypothesis tests for population proportions. We also learned how to apply the 5 steps for hypothesis testing to population proportions. Thanks for watching, and be sure to check out other videos about statistics lessons and applications here on Chegg. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.